Tired of dealing with annoying flies, fruit flies, and gnats in your home? The Zevo Flying Insect Trap is your ultimate solution. Don't wait. Check out the link in the video description now to get your Zevo Flying Insect Trap on Amazon and enjoy a bug-free home today.
The Tuesday Letters page worries that the perceived value of games consoles is shrinking, as one reader asks if Space Marine 2 is coming to Game Pass. Taking a guess. So it's Gamescom this week, which I always meant to go to pre-pandemic but never got around to. As I understand, it's the opening night live stream on Tuesday night, so I guess I might stay up for that if it's not too late. Although I'm not sure what to really expect, aka get disappointed by when it's not there. Borderlands 4 I think was debunked as a possibility. Resident Evil 9 feels like it should be announced soonish, but I haven't heard anything about that being there either. I like the idea of Tomb Raider being shown though. They've got a new animated show coming up and it's years since we've heard anything, so I'm putting that down on my bingo card as a prediction. I would also love to see Mass Effect 4 as well, but I don't think they're going to say anything about that until the new Dragon Age is out and they know how that's done. Still, lots of possibilities. Now just watch it being a bunch of DLC and other disappointments. Remember, the trick with these events is to accept nothing and hopefully be pleasantly surprised. Gonch. Changing the conversation. Great to hear that Silent Hill 2 was good after all. Glad they gave you plenty of time to play it. I'll be honest, I've never heard of Bloober Team before, but the relentless negativity had made me pretty much give up on the game already. And yet as soon as there's positive previews, as far as I can see most sites agree with GC, suddenly everyone's interested again and, if you look at the likes versus dislikes on the latest trailer, nobody's complaining anymore. I really think publishers are being stupid with this idea of not talking about games until they're almost out. Sure, nobody wants to hear about a game nonstop for 3 years, but they've gone so far the other way that even massive games are being released with no proper build-up or information. I really don't see what was wrong with the old way of doing things. When E3 was still a thing, it seems like we had just the right balance of hype and information. I could understand if things were going wrong last gen, but it's this gen where the wheels have come off everything, and that's when they changed how everything works. Maybe take that as proof that the new way of doing things isn't a good idea? Anyone, count me as interested for the review and final release of Silent Hill 2. Fugu. Declining worth. I think a huge challenge to console manufacturers and games developers is that the perceived value of gaming isn't rising in line with how much stuff actually costs. A bucket of chicken is £20 nowadays and delivers around 30 minutes of pure bliss, but a 20 to 40 hour game costing £70 seems outlandish. Yes, I'm comparing delicious food to entertainment. But the standard cinema analogy is very well worn. Ditto consoles. The PlayStation 3 was £400 nearly 20 years ago, the PlayStation 4 was £350 10 years ago, but many can't compute paying over £300 for a console in 2024. I don't think that's a problem that the Xbox 2X or the PlayStation 6 launching early would solve. To me, they'd be better doubling down on the current consoles and showing why these games are worth the investment, rather than rushing into the next, inevitably even more expensive generation. Magnum Stash. Currently playing BioShock Remastered on Steam Deck. Crashes about once per session, but what a game. GC, what are you doing with that bucket of chicken? Email your comments to gamecentral@metro.co.uk. The long wait. With the Switch 2 starting to enter production, how likely is it that we'll get some kind of leak as to what it looks like slash what it does? I seem to remember pics or descriptions of the PlayStation 5 leaked out early, so I assume there's a chance. I shouldn't really hope for it, I guess, because it's always better to get an official announcement, but I really want to just get to the point where we know what it is and can start looking forward to it, with some real game details, and prices, and a date. It reminds me of that old South Park episode where Cartman freezes himself until, was it the Wii or Xbox 360 comes out? If that was a possibility, I'd do it. Josh. GC. It has happened before, but it's rare and never with a Nintendo console, unless there's one we're forgetting. Wrong direction. I agree with.